Let's do something funky. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki, I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today, my first impression of the Juvia's Coral 3 Nubian. Wow, that was apparently very difficult to say. But yeah, if you don't know what she looks like, this is the color story. And the reason that I got this is I got sucked in by the gray. The combination of that coral and then that silvery gray, that's what got me. And then when I got the palette, I was like, I did use her once already in my Doctor Who collaboration. I will link it underneath the cards, but I only played up here. I don't remember if I also used this one or just this one. I don't remember. But I did play with a few of the shades, but I wasn't really trying to formulate my thoughts in that video. Does that make any sense? Oh, if you do not like spooky things, maybe you should not watch that video. Just a disclaimer. What I'm going to do though, is I'm going to swatch her. And then I can kind of see what I want to do with it, you know? Also, what is kind of weird and annoying is that this does not have any shade names underneath. It doesn't have any shade names, period. So I think that it is, I don't know, maybe something that was released really, really quickly, you know? I don't know. I don't know what to make of it. What do you want? My laptop is annoying me because it wants to update immediately. Or something like that. And I don't know. Yes, install now, you idiot. Shut it. It just do... Where was I again? Before my laptop so rudely interrupted me. Anyway, yeah. So I kind of think that this is, I don't know, I got a little bit of afterthought vibes. Like, oh yeah, let's kind of do something for spring. You know, I don't know what to make of it. But yeah, the artwork is very, very pretty though. I love the artwork. Although, yeah, this is kind of goldish. And there is not really goldish in the palette. I do think it's a unique color story though. And pretty controversial because you either love it or you hate it apparently. So yeah, I'm going to take a sip of coffee. Then I'm going to get a makeup wipe. I'm going to swatch row by row like I usually do. Starting at this corner and then going like that. And she will be swatched on a bare clean arm without any primer. So yeah. So yeah, let me see if I can build up, I don't know even what kind of color, it's not really a gray. It doesn't want to show up. So yeah, sorry about that. The grays, they don't swatch the best. This shade doesn't swatch the best either. But you know, it's all about how they perform on the eyes. The shimmers though, they are so freaking pretty. They look gorgeous. I still don't know what I want to do though. This is really pretty. And then maybe with a gray crease. Or orange crease and gray. Silvery gray. That would be pretty too, I think. So I think I have decided that I want to do a corally or orangey crease. And then these two silvery grays on the lid. Something like that will happen, probably. So let me prime my eyes with the MAC Paint Pot today. I haven't done my base. So yeah, just some primer. I do have to say, this is the first time that I'm using the MAC Paint Pot on, well, basically a bare lid. Usually I have at least concealer or foundation on my eye before I go in with eye base, but it actually goes on really, really nicely now. Anyway, like that. So yeah, eyes are primed and almost ready to go. I do want to let it sit just a second so I can get a little bit of coffee, get my brushes ready, and then we can get started with putting eyeshadows on my eye. I hope. But I think so. Yeah, I think I can do that today. Okay. Okay, let's start with usually start with you, then I don't know, people. I don't know. I have here the Morphe M506, which is small, and this color, which does not have a name. It is a brownish orange. I'm going to place it in the crease. I'm just going to tap it on. The trouble with this palette is I don't really know what to do with it. If I'm being completely honest. Because it's not kind of corally enough. It's, I don't know, a weird kind of neutral palette. Does that make any sense? I don't know. Also, I actually thought that it would be kind of brighter. A brighter orange. But it wasn't. But yeah. I do, however, see this as an everyday palette for a lot of people. Especially if you like oranges, you know? It's not specifically an everyday palette for me. But yeah. Next, I'm going to kind of blend everything out a little bit on the edge. Just a tiny bit to soften it up. Then I'm going to take this one, which is the lightest of the oranges. And maybe a bit of the brightest as well. I'm going to use that to blend out. And to make it a bit more orange. So they are pretty similar in tone. Especially when you put them on your eye. Now I haven't even watched reviews of this. Because I didn't want it to influence my opinion, you know. Is it me or is it blending away? With this same brush I'm going to go back into the previous color. I'm just going to add a little bit of depth, I hope. Okay. Then I'm going to go into the darkest shade, which is, well, basically a brown. Let me think first. Yeah, I am. I'm going to deepen up the crease a little bit with that brown first. Switching brushes to the brush I just used, the bigger one, in the same brown. Because apparently I'm having trouble blending today. This just makes it a bit easier. I'm going to go back to this color again. Just going to place a light wash on top. Okay, it all kind of tends to melt together, which is... yeah, kind of the idea though, isn't it? But yeah, okay. Now I'm going to do something different, I think. I'm going to go into this color, this matte darkest gray. And I'm going to deepen up the outer corner. And lay down kind of a base for the shimmer shade. In the outer corner, that is. Now, this is a nice shade. That's very, very, very pretty. Going to work it into the crease, whatever I have left on the brush. Now, this shade I am impressed by. In my experience, grays are difficult. This one, though. Blends nicely. Not patchy. Yeah, I'm more impressed by this gray than with the oranges, to be quite honest. Okay, next it's shimmer time, and I haven't used my NYX Glitter Primer in my first impressions during the first impression period, so I'm not going to do it now either. I am, however, going to go into this shade. It's going to go on my lid. It's dry. Yeah, I'm not hating this at all. This is like molten metal. It's so pretty. Let's do something funky. Because why not? I'm going to go into this shade, which is the brightest of the orange shimmers. It's going to go in the inner part of my eye. It's also dry. I do feel fallout, but again, it's dry and the brush I'm using is very small. So just so you know, it's also pretty dusty in the pan, or dusty. I have kick up in the pan with this shade. So either, if you don't want that, do your eyes first like I'm doing now, or spray your brush. That's usually the way to kind of combat it. Yeah, I think this is cute. To be quite honest. So what I'm going to do now is the base makeup, eyebrows and all that goodness. And then I will be back and we will finish off the eye look with the bottom lashes. Or the lower lash line. So yeah, that's the plan. I'm going to finish my coffee and then put on my base makeup. And I will see you in just a little bit. So the rest of my makeup is on and I'm ready to finish off the eye look. Everything I have on my face will be down in the description box. Let's get a tiny brush. Let's get you. No, let's get you. I want this shade underneath. First, I really need to learn to finish my sentence. In one go, and not, you know, like 5 minutes after. Yeah, I have here the L'Oreal Infallible Gel Crayon in Rust in Khaki. But when I swatch it, it's this. It's kind of a little bit more grayish. So let's put that in the waterline. Yes, okay. Then let's get this one, which was the darkest gray shimmer on a pencil brush. It's going to go on top of my lash line. Now I'm going to connect it as well, just to make sure it's all nice and whatever. Connected, basically. Yes. Do I need a little bit in that corner? Yes, I do. So I'm going to go into the darkest gray matte, same brush. I'm just going to make sure that the corners here are nice. Because of my, well, the way my eyes are shaped, I just, you know, look forward and then just draw a line. That's basically what I do. Okay, I'm going to go back to that gray shimmer. I'm going to place it on top and then pull it on top of my lash upper lid. Now, the inner part of my lid, I'm cleaning my tiny brush. For the inner part of my lid, I'm going to grab this shade, which is the same that I have on top. It's going to go in the inner part of my eye. I feel like I'm not making sense today, which is not weird. But yeah. Okay, let's get my face highlight and see what I can do with that. So I'm getting a different brush. For face highlight, I have the Essence Glow To Go palette and I used this shade here, which is, I don't know, number 2? I don't know. It's a little bit of a peachy one. So let's put that in the inner corner, see what it does. I think it adds a little bit of brightness. I like it. I am going to do liner and mascara and I'll be right back to show you the look just before my falsies. So here is the look just before the falsies. For a liner I use the Primark Tulip Tip Eyeliner because my Renaissance Flick is, well, basically done. And I want to finish this one up before I open up a new Renaissance Flick. Yes? So yeah. And for mascara, the Catrice Glam & Doll in Waterproof, which is a very nice dupe for the Bad Gal Bang, but a lot cheaper. So yeah, oh yeah, and it's waterproof, which is always good. Do I need to clean my head? Probably. Yes, so let me do that real quick as well. Then I will put on my falsies and the lipstick, and I will, well, finish off the video with my first impression thoughts on the Nubian 3 by Juvia's Place. Falsies on, lippy on, here is the finished look. I like it. I like how it turned out. It's nice and soft still, but still a little bit more dramatic. And I really love the combination of the orange and the silvery gray. I think it's really, really pretty. I paired it with a gloss because, yeah, I thought it would be appropriate. I don't know. I thought this would be the prettiest. That's basically it. The gloss is from Essence. It's one of their high shine glosses. The Shine, Shine, Shine. This is in the color Let's Pumpkin Up. The falsies are my kind of natural ones, the Social Glam Lash Collection in Style London. And they are the natural ones because I didn't feel like cutting my dramatic ones to length, because I need to break out a new pair. And I'm actually glad that I picked these because I think they go very, very nicely with the look. Okay, let me give you my first impression on the Juvia's Place Nubian 3 Coral. Well, first off, there's gold in the packaging and not in the palette. That's one. However, I really... Wow. Do it like this. I really like the fact that they paired the gray and the silvers with the oranges. That is what I really, really like. If I were to grab this palette, it would be specifically for the gray matte, the dark gray matte, and the silvers, and then, well, basically the other shimmers. Probably need to play with it a bit more. What do I have here? What do I have there? Huh. Is it gone? Gone-ish. Wow. Probably because I dug my fingers somewhere in the palette. So yeah. So yeah, do I think it's worth its money? It's not specifically worth it for me, but that is also because I don't usually gravitate towards these kinds of tones. I wish that the orange mattes were a little bit more orange matte and less brown matte. Does that make any sense? I do really, really like this color though, and I think that the shimmers are gorgeous. I used them dry and they were very, very good. So yeah, what I would grab this palette for is the gray matte, the dark gray matte, then these two, and probably the shimmers. But this, what I have on my eyes now, is kind of what I would use this palette for. So either an orangey crease and then gray on the lid, or vice versa. So yeah, but I can see this being an everyday palette for some people. It's just not my everyday palette. I think the shimmer quality is amazing. I think the dark gray matte is amazing. The rest of the mattes, yeah, they're nice, but not really what my preference is. Do I make any sense? I hope so. So yeah guys, let me know if you have this palette, if you want the palette, how you feel about the palette and all that goodness. Maybe there is a specific color combination that you want me to do with this palette. Let me know down in the comment section below. I do really like how this look turned out, but again, this is, well, if I want a look like this, this is the palette that I would grab. That's basically it. If I think about the Nubian 3 Coral, the shades I think about are the grays, which is kind of weird, but yeah, so am I. So what can you do about it? This was it for me though. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so very much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you soon in my next one, which is, I think, tomorrow. So yeah, bye guys.